Y Combinator has funded some of the most valuable companies in the world, including Airbnb, DoorDash, and Coinbase. So I always like to see the new companies that they fund, especially in the vibe coding space, because they might have funded the next best tool. One tool that I just came across is called Bloom. They're funded by Y Combinator, and they promise to be lovable for building native mobile apps. So in this video, we're going to test it out together. And by the end of the video, you're going to see if Bloom is worth your time and if you should try it out yourself. So we're testing this out right now. The prompt I used was create a habit tracker app with a clean, minimalist iOS style interface. Right off the bat, I am really impressed with the design of Bloom. I like what they did on the left side and the right side here. Of course, it's similar to other vibe coding tools that you might have seen, like Lovable or Bolt, but they do have a bit of a different design, and I really like it. On the right side, we have the iOS app, basically wrapper. So we're going to see what it looks like inside an app, because that is the promise of Bloom, is that it's going to be able to build native mobile apps. This differs from tools like Base44, Lovable, Bolt, in that those tools are really meant for web apps. Now, the only other two vibe coding tools that I would say this competes with in terms of building native mobile apps are Rork and Dreamflow. So those are two other tools that we've made videos on in the past. So I'm really curious to see how this compares and if it really builds high quality apps. While it's building this first version, let's just go around the dashboard here to see what some of our options are. Looks like we have a smart model and then a fast model for half the cost. Looks like we have 350 free daily credits to use, and with also a 700 credit monthly limit before you have to start paying. So you can try this for yourself. Click the link and go to bloom.diy to try it out. Then it looks like on the top, you can download the source code, restart the server, and preview it on your device as well. But first, let's see what it comes up with on this first draft. On the left side, we have a code view. We also have something called a Convex backend. So this is basically the database to see what backend database is stored in your app. They're using Convex for the database. So that's an open source database that they've basically built in and integrated. So it doesn't look like we have to sign up for a different service. It just all seems to be integrated in one, which is great. We have logs as well, which can be really helpful for testing and debugging. And then it looks like we have settings for restarting the development environment and looking at the backend settings as well. And finally, there is a GitHub sync. Looks like that is on the premium plan. I'm currently testing on the free plan, but this is also a really great feature. I always like seeing this with tools, so you're not locked in and you can sync with GitHub, have your code on GitHub. That I really like as well. So it says it finished creating the first version with a clean iOS design, habit management, daily tracking, visual feedback, progress overview, and a lot more. So let's test it out and actually see how it works. So I'm going to go ahead, click add. We can add a habit of exercise. We can add another one of meditation. It looks like there's just four that they've built in there. If I click check off, it'll basically just say it's done today. So really simple, basic version for the first version of this app. I want to see in the back end. Yes. Yeah, so it is actually saving this in the back end, which is really cool. Okay, so let's go back to the chat. And why don't I ask it to build on top of this? So I'd say I want a page to view for users to view their streaks and history. So we now have our streaks feature built on the bottom right, and pretty cool. So we have our stats and it's all working, which is pretty impressive. It did this all really quickly. So far, I am impressed with what I'm seeing. I have a couple questions in my head of what I want to know if it can do. One, I'm wondering if you can add user authentication so users can log in. And then I also wonder if you can add in-app payments to this. So why don't I first just ask Bloom this and see, can I add in user authentication so users can log in? Also, is it possible to add in-app payment? And that's that question. While doing that, I'm just going to quickly show you this preview on device tab, where you can scan your phone and actually preview it yourself. Then to actually deploy it to an app store, you would just download the code and then here you need to upgrade, but then you can deploy to any hosting platform or app store from there. All right, so we got an explanation for authentication. It says it can implement that using Convex Auth, which will allow users to log in, which is great. And then for payments, it recommends Revenue Cat to manage subscription, et cetera. Can also use Stripe native store billing, and then it can guide us through the Revenue Cat setup for payments. Cool that it says it can do that. I don't think I'm going to go through that whole payments flow on this tutorial or the authentication on this tutorial, but it should be as easy as just asking it to do that. I'm very confident that the Convex auth will work since that is a Convex backend. In-app payments are always a little bit more difficult, but I think it should work with Revenue Cat as well. But leave a comment if you've tried this and how it works with Bloom, and also subscribe to our channel. We'll do a follow-up video to do payments in more detail. All right, so far I am really impressed with Bloom. Again, let me know in the comments what you think. Subscribe to our channel for future videos and also to get more free AI content. And if you want to learn how to build your own AI apps, we built an in-depth course teaching how to do this. We have the first lesson completely for free. Click the link in the description to get that first lesson and start building with AI tools like Lovable, Cursor, and much more. So hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.